Hi, let's talk about how to track and compare changes in Excel macros. The version control tool for VBA projects can help you with that. Here is how it works. For example, you have this macro-enabled spreadsheet with invoices. You want to track who changed what and when. First, you need to enable developer macro settings. Just check the box Trust Access to the VBA Project Object Model. Next, enable version control. Go to XLTools tab and just click Enable. Now you are tracking changes and history of this workbook and its macros. Once you enable version control, a Git repository is automatically generated in the same destination as the workbook. It safely stores the revision history and doesn't take much disk space. To save a version, you need to commit it to changelog. Let's save this initial version of the workbook. Simply click Commit Changes and type Initial version. Now, for example, you want to update the macro. Let's do that and commit this version. Add a descriptive comment to explain the changes you have just made. You also want to add new information about invoices. Some invoices were paid and a new invoice was issued. Commit the version as well. We recommend you commit a version after any critical modifications in the spreadsheet. Now, for example, you want to make some more changes to the VBA script. Commit the version just the same. To see all the saved versions, review the changelog. You can easily filter and find the version you need. You can see who made the changes and when, and you can do much more. Diff versions, roll back, open or save any previous version, and also see what exactly was changed. Let's compare these two versions of the VBA module. The older and the newer revisions will display side by side. The modified lines are highlighted. If you have Microsoft Inquire add-in on your computer, you can also compare changes there. The version control tool for VBA projects helps you track and compare changes made to a macro in a spreadsheet. And you can always roll back to any previous version. Add XLTools add-in into your Excel and try it yourself.